Everybody, Phil with American Liberty Fighters. Saturday, May 20th. Figured I'd put a video out here real quick. I guess you could categorize this more as a rant than anything. Maybe a rant, channel update, whatever you want to call it. But I apologize for not putting a video out before this, to be quite honest, though. I haven't really felt like putting a video out. I've had a lot of things going on, a lot on my mind. I guess let's see. We'll go back to the beginning of the month, just to give you guys a background synopsis, however you want to look at it. My wife and I, of course, we've been renting a place here in Van Alstyne, Texas, since selling our house and purchasing our homestead up in Arkansas, so that we could start preparing our cabin and everything for us moving up there and gradually get everything there, so that it wouldn't be such a big change, a big shift, such a stressful move. We wanted to have some things already set up and ready to go, so that we could kind of like, I guess, hit the ground running when we got there. After putting in our written notice to our landlord here that we would not be renewing our monthly lease here, things kind of changed with the way the landlord basically became the landlord from hell, the psycho landlord idiot from hell. To begin with, he decided that he would accept our written notice, albeit it was through email. This is just, you know, a lot of things going on. But he accepted our written notice that we were going to vacate and that we were actually going to be out of here as quickly as possible. That we were asking for the first few weeks just to get as much as we could packed and moved out. That, of course, he told us was not going to happen because he had rights after all. He's the landlord. He's the owner of the place. And, well, by God, he can show it anytime he wants. And that's what he kind of started to do. The first time he did it, it took him over 2 hours to show the place and leave, which was unacceptable. I paid rent. I paid it on time. I've never been late on my rent. I've been a very quiet, good tenant. I know my rights, and he's infringed upon my rights. So I'm kind of pissed. So that began the fiasco that we'll call the last month of our renting from an asshole. Sorry, just how I look at it. That's how it is. I apologize for the profanity. If you don't want to hear it, you may as well click off now, because I'm probably going to go a few more rounds with calling him some names or saying some things you probably won't like, because I'm, like I said, kind of pissed. And the more I talk about it, the more pissed I get. But who can blame me? After all, he's done quite a few things that I, myself, as a landlord, would never have done. And I've been a landlord before. And I would never treat people the way he's treated us. Case in point, from the moment we started renting, we were never told that the place never had mail delivered to it before. Which means that we had to verify E911 service and get the mail service to actually verify and allow us to have an address here. Which means that we had to go buy a mailbox and put a mailbox outside, because he sure as hell wasn't going to do it. Let's see, what else did we have to do? In order to get our internet service here, because my wife, of course, runs a business from home, and I, as a technician, I work remotely from home at times. We have to have high-speed internet, which we told our landlord that we needed to have. He says no problem. However, every single internet provider here says it's a problem. We have copper DSL line, 1 meg, one measly meg of internet speed. Not quite high speed, if you ask me. In order to, just to explain, for me to put this video up, which is probably going to be about a 15, 20 minute video, I don't know, and if you don't want to listen to the whole thing, click off now, go watch somebody else, no problem. But in order to upload this video and have it all done, it'll probably take me from today till late tonight to get it out there and uploaded and ready to go with 1 meg service. Go figure. I guess we put up with it, I suppose, whatever. But once we got in here, these are the things we were finding out once we got into the place. I mean, he told us a lot of things up front that just weren't very true. So a lot of these things were, we figured it out after moving in. Let's see. Oh, and his habit of always driving around this place all the time, back and forth, on a tractor, on a UTV, on a riding lawnmower, using a chipper, whatever. He's all over the place during the day when I'm not home, aggravating my wife, harassing my wife. I get here, he's rarely out here. I don't know why. Weekends, same thing. Hardly ever around here. You would think that if you're doing yard work, you'd do it on the weekends. I don't know. And then if you he never actually mowed the lawn while we were here up until 2 weeks ago. And that was after I sent him a message asking him what the lawn mowing schedule was, because the lawn was over knee high here. We were told, sorry. His mower was broke. He had to take his mother-in-law in for surgery. He was going in for surgery. We had all these little things that were going on. So I actually told him I'd mow for him if he wanted me to, which he said, great, he'd appreciate it. So I mowed. So, we'll get back to that in a little bit, because that's the main reason I'm pissed. Well, we go back and we look at it. When we first moved in, we knew we were going to have a hot water issue. We didn't know how much of an issue, but we knew it would be a little bit of an issue. 20-gallon hot water heater, 2 adults, there's going to be an issue. We didn't know, however, that there was going to be a water issue. You can't drink the water here. It's something up with the water. I don't know what it is. I buy water. I won't drink this water. Grayson County, you have a problem with your water. I don't know what to tell you. Let's see. Oh, trash service. Evidently in Grayson County, according to our illustrious, ignorant landlord, they only allow you so much trash. And since he's a landlord, he gets to tell you what kind of trash you can have out there, when you can have it out there, and how much. Which he didn't tell us when we first rented. But we were told shortly thereafter, like I think the second, third week, something like that, that we were only allowed 1 large black trash bag of trash, and it had to be taken out the morning of the trash pickup, which is Mondays, which means from Monday after trash pickup, when you take your trash out, until the following Monday, you have to hold all your trash. And where are you going to hold it? You can't hold it outside, because they don't actually keep stray dogs and stray animals out of your area. They don't control it. People just let their animals run wild over here. So you can't put it outside, or you'll get it all strewn all over your yard. And of course, then you break the lease because you didn't keep your yard clean. But of course, that wouldn't matter really, would it? Because according to our landlord, we're not leasing the yard. We're just leasing the house, the 2 parking lots, the porch, and the dog area, which is like a 5x10 area. Kind of a little jail for the dogs. So, been quite a few different little things that we're not too thrilled about. Then we can fast forward to 3 weeks ago, I guess it was, on a Thursday. My wife goes to the store, comes back home, parks her vehicle. Brand new Jeep. She just got it, just a couple weeks ago. It was a gift from her son. He gifted her a vehicle. And this jackass decides, since he's over here across the way mowing his field and doesn't want to finish evidently mowing the field, he wants to come across here and start mowing our area, which is where he's mowing at over on this side of the house. where our parking area is just gravel and dirt and nothing much more than that. He's mowing that area, throwing rocks and crap all over my wife's Jeep that she just washed. And it's, you know, I mean, are you, how stupid do you got to be? So then he comes around the other side of it, and he's flinging rocks and crap all over it from that side. My wife hears all this going on, goes outside to try to get him stopped. Waves her off like, who cares? Leave me alone. I'm mowing. When he doesn't need to mow because, well, I already mowed and it didn't need to be mowed. My wife goes and stands by her vehicle, and this asshat decides he's actually going to try and pin her between his mower and her vehicle with his mower. So she has to push him to get him away from her. Not once, but twice. So she calls the police. They show up. She calls me. I'm on my way. I show up. I'm on the phone with her when the cop gets here. He talks to her for maybe 30 seconds to a minute. Leaves to go talk to the owner, the landlord. And he's down there forever. Comes back and tells us all we're acting like little children. We need to leave each other alone. And that basically my wife is the one that assaulted the landlord. He didn't assault her. Although he's the one that tried to pin her against her vehicle in between his tractor and her vehicle, or his mower and her vehicle, twice, making her push him. Which, by Texas law, if you were to go by Texas law, there's Castle law or Stand Your Ground law, if you're from the Stand Your Ground state, which means she can defend herself. And she was. She was defending her vehicle and herself. So she's defending her property and her person. Legally. So, I don't know. It's just aggravatingly, irritatingly stupid individual down the road here. And he thinks he has the right to do all this stuff. So, I'm told I'm not supposed to text him, not supposed to do anything with him. I'm supposed to leave him alone. So, I'm leaving him alone. He's texting me, telling me I'm breaking the lease, and all these good things. Sends a certified letter telling us that we are in default of our lease, which according to the lease, the unsigned, unfilled out form that we got when we first started asking him about this place, according to that lease, it says that he's to give us 7 days after telling us that we have a deficiency or that we're in default of the lease to fix it, or he can fix it. I don't have hardly anything left here since last week, since last Friday. Nothing. Since over a week ago, everything's been on a budget truck up in Arkansas, being put in a cabin up there. I have very little left here, so I'm really not in default of the lease. He told me I could have certain things here. I had them here. End of story. Told us we couldn't do things. We didn't do them. Followed the lease. That he failed to give us a copy of, signed and dated, which is his job to do. So, I mean, seriously? Again, we're dealing with an idiot. What are you going to do? So here I am. I've taken my wife up to Arkansas last Friday, spent the weekend with her up there unloading, unpacking, getting things settled in. Didn't get to do the things we needed to do. I mean, weather was a factor, so a lot of rain up there. I didn't get to get everything I needed to get done for her done. But she didn't feel safe. She didn't feel secure here. She's here alone during the day, so she didn't want to be here with him here. So I had to get her up there and get her out of here so that she'd feel safe. Kind of odd. You feel safer out in the middle of nowhere with all the wildlife around you when you're a city girl. But got to give it to my wife. She's a trooper. She has hung in there, made it a whole week. She had an incident with a snake inside the bedroom, a baby snake, a little rat snake. But she took care of that. And evidently we have some scorpions up there that are coming out from somewhere that we're going to have to deal with at some point. So, I've got to deal with that kind of stuff, and you know, I'll be getting up there here as soon as possible. So I'm just, like I said, I'm down here. I'm finishing clearing out this place, cleaning it up, and moving out of here. I've recently, what was it? I think Tuesday or Wednesday of last week, my landlord decided to tape a note on our door here because I won't reply to any of his texts since I'm not supposed to, and he's harassing me with the texts. I've declined to get into any kind of correspondence with him over text or email, and have told him that since he wants to act like a little petulant bitch, that he can go ahead and send me certified through the Postal Service mail in whatever he needs me to do, because that's what he wants to correspond through. So if he wants to say that that's what it says in the lease, then he, by God, better go by it. And of course, I'm not here during the day, so I'm never going to get it. And by the time I do, it's too late. I'll be gone. Don't care. So I'll be back up in Arkansas by next Friday. Probably leaving Friday, Saturday, sometime around midnight. Between midnight and 2 a.m., I'll be heading out Saturday morning. So to get up there with what else I'm going to take up there this trip. And we will no longer be here. But, stress-free, getting out of here, not having to deal with an idiot. So I guess that's my rant for now. Anybody who's thinking of moving to the country and you're thinking of Van Alstyne, Texas as an area to move to, Eagle Point Realty Company, Eagle Point Real Estate, or whatever he goes by, Calvin Hall, run. Don't go near him. Don't talk to him. Don't take him on. Don't rent from him. Don't buy from him. He's a thief. He's not an honest man. He's got something wrong with him. So, just renter, buyer beware. If you're in this area and you deal with Calvin Hall, I feel sorry for you. So, I guess, that's pretty much all I've got today. I've gone and ranted for way too long. Anyhow, I hope everybody else is having a better month. And I guess I'll see everybody on the next video.